This is chapter 14, database connectivity and web technology. I've been doing this for quite a while, and I don't know if I was fortunate or unfortunate to grow with this industry. And once again, in some of the prior videos you've seen me talk about different scenarios. And let's take this scenario for example. Let's go back to those doctor's offices. So you have a bunch of doctors, and they golf on Wednesdays and Thursdays. And what's happening is they're sitting there and they're complaining about how they don't have the resources to really dedicate to technology. So, you know, you begin with the central office, you go to the south office, you go to the north office, and this was a 95, this is a 2000, and this is an 05. And then they're gonna build, you know, this town is growing, so they're gonna relocate a new office in some suburb. So you have a suburb up here, and they're gonna have another office in 2013. Okay, now what happens is you have age technology. So you have different issues there that you have to take care of. And one of the things that happen is, as time goes on and this happens, what level of technology existed in 95? What was the level of technology in 2000? What was the level of technology in 05? Now, in 1995, the web was in its infancy. So the hardware software that was loaded really wasn't meant to work on the internet. And then in 2000, the internet started to come alive, but it really, really wasn't as active as it is today. And then by the year 2000, it really had a foothold. And then by the year 2013, well, it's full blown. Now what's happening here is there's been an evolution that has happened. Now, what you need is, you need some kind of middle of the road process to be able to connect all these items. So we're looking for something that's in the middle that you can use to connect everything. And by coincidence, it's called middleware. So what you do is you have different levels of technology that you have to kind of integrate. Now, the initial item is always by the vendor, because the vendor will always devise something, you know, because they want to sell something to you. So a vendor will always come in and try to sell you something that's going to work. Well, that's good to a point, but then when you have all these different brands, you need something that will integrate different technologies. And Microsoft, being at the forefront of all this, came up with an item called ODBC, Open Database Connection. Now, once again, as time has evolved, somewhere when the web started to come in, there was another item called ActiveX that was used to manage a lot of these items. And once again, as time went on, another item came called Java, and I'm sure many of you now are familiar with Java. So what we're looking for is these items. Now here's the example. You have a process that connects all these, and then you have this to connect that. So what you have to do is develop some methodology that will connect all these. But then on top of that, somewhere over here, you have a vendor for medical supplies. And then over here, you have a vendor for office supplies. Now, your office has to talk to these items, and they have different requirements. The office supply, if you mess up an order of pens or paper, that's not an issue. So the security scenario, the hookup scenario here is not as intense. However, in the medical environment, boy, you can have some real tight requirements to do that. So in this scenario, we have real tight requirements, you may do a vendor event, because that is more secure. But down here, you may get something that's off the shelf that you can work with. Now, one of the items that we're going to deal with is the government is the biggest consumer in the United States. And they cannot tell you how to build something. But they can say, if I'm gonna buy it from you, this is what it has to do. So somewhere along the line, these companies got together, because if a computer company on the West Coast and a computer company on the East Coast were gonna build a computer and sell it to the government said, I don't care how you do it, but machine A has to talk to machine B. So the vendors, in order to be more competitive, yes, the machine is proprietary, but there's a generic translation mechanism that allows different brands of computers to talk to each other. And this happens to be the SQL language. And right now we're looking at a 1999 standard. That is the ANSI standard that most vendors push. So this is the generic translation language that happens in amongst all these items. So all these will translate to SQL, we'll go to SQL, Java, we'll go to SQL. So this is the language that is manageable, and these are the tools that manage that language. So what we're looking here, what's the word I'm gonna look for? Incompatibility. In this scenario, in 1995, you had like an 8-bit processor. In 2000, you have a 16-bit processor. In 05, you have a 32-bit processor. And over here, you have a 64-bit processor. So now that you have this kind of issue that you have to resolve, it does make a difference on how you do this. So you're going to be hired to fix this problem. How do you fix it? Where do you go? What do you find? Well, all these have native items that you can deal with. So you figure out, what do I have, what tools are available, and what are the solutions that you're looking for.